And in this apartment, there was none.
Did your neighbor say anything else about the maid?
Yes, I was going to say it. It turned out that it was Marie Capet, my old classmate. We grew up in the same city, and I had not known that she had moved to Paris.
So you admit that you knew the victim?
Oui, I knew who she was. I opened the door to the living room of Monsieur Brissot. I was curious to see behind the door, but did not want to offend my host by nosing around. I knew how he is attached to the etiquette. Then I opened the door and left the apartment. I decided to use the stairs instead of the elevator. I knocked, but no one answered. I checked the light switch to see if it was already repaired, but it still didn't work. Then I opened the door to my apartment and entered. I watched the frames hanging on the wall. I loved their simplicity. It enhanced my creativity. For a moment, I admired the new sculptures that I had recently ordered. I tried to play something on the piano. I must add that I cannot play, and the piano is just for decoration. I opened the inner door. Then I put my groceries into the cabinet. I ate the leftovers from my lunch and drank some wine. I opened the inner door. For a moment, I admired the new sculptures that I had recently ordered. I opened the inner door. I used the stairs. I checked the elements of my cleaning machine, assessing what remained to be done. Then I opened the door. Behind my bookcase, leading to my second workshop.
Can you explain to the court why you have a hidden workshop?
I work there on my secret projects that I create independently of Le Feu.
I understand. Please continue.
My journal, in which I described the construction process of my interrogation machine, was on my desk. Monsieur le Président, this is the evidence marked with number 3. It clearly shows that my client had only his best intentions during the construction of his interrogation device. According to his plan, it would be forwarded to the prosecutor's office and law enforcement agencies in order to improve the effectiveness of interrogation. My client also wrote that the first test of the machine would be conducted under the supervision of the Ministère de la Justice.
Thank you, Counselor. The accused may return to his testimony.
Then I turned down my prototype machine to interrogate prisoners. I turned off my prototype machine to interrogate prisoners. I picked up the mechanical dagger lying on the desk.
Why do you need a weapon, Monsieur Eaton?
I wear it to ensure my safety.
Do you feel unsafe?
I am a wealthy gypsy. At least one-third of the population of this city wants me dead.
I understand. Please continue.
I read for a while about the history of torture.
Are you interested in this subject?
It is not about hurting someone, but to use pain as one of the methods to convince someone to testify.
Do you think it is acceptable to inflict pain during the interrogation?
In extreme cases, yes. But my device is not inflicting it. And the prosecutor naming my device the torture machine only shows his deep ignorance on that subject.
Order, please. And I admonish the accused to make no offense to any of the participants of this trial. Please, return to your testimony.
I opened a hidden door behind my bookcase, leading to my second workshop. Then I opened the door. I used the stairs. I heard someone knocking at the door. I opened it, and there she was, Marie Capet. She saw my condition, and it apparently got her upset, but I assured her that everything was in order. I invited Marie Capet inside. She said she remembered me from school and was curious how things turned out for me. She had been recently hired as a maid by my neighbor, Monsieur Brissot. I showed her my apartment, my designs and inventions. She was delighted. So I thought maybe she would be interested in my interrogation machine. I took her to my private workshop. ¶¶ checked if the designs of my most important invention were still in place. Then I turned down my prototype machine to interrogate prisoners. Then I felt a blow to my head, and I collapsed on the floor. I woke up some time later. My head ached, and I was all covered in blood. Marie Capet was nowhere to be found. I picked up the mechanical dagger lying on the desk. I saw a metal rod on the ground. I saw that the safe was open, and Capet had stolen the designs of my most important invention.
Why do you think Madame Capet did it?
I don't know, Monsieur le Président, but I was going to find out. I saw a metal rod on the ground. There was blood on it. My blood. I used the stairs. I opened the door and walked out into the stairwell. Then I used the stairs. Then I opened the door. I opened the door and walked out into the street. For a moment, I admired. Then I opened the gate. I opened the door and walked into the Caucasus Hotel.
I've just received an urgent package from the Procureur de la République containing new evidence in the case. I ask both the parties to get acquainted with it. It is a letter from the attorney's office from 1 week before the murder, which calls Alfred Eaton in attendance to forward the designs of the invention which he has constructed in secret from Le Feu Company. The firm acted on behalf of the president of the company, Hugo Argent. Monsieur Eaton, have you received the letter?
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
When did you receive it?
I don't remember exactly, but probably on the 10th of October.
So, exactly 1 week before the murder?
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
Which designs are mentioned in this letter?
Designs of my secret invention on which I was working in my free time. It has no connection with Le Feu.
Therefore, why did the firm send you this letter on behalf of Hugo Argent?
Hugo must have guessed what great potential my invention had and how profitable it could be.
Did you keep your designs in your apartment?
Oui, Monsieur le Président, in the safe in my secret workshop.
Due to the new circumstances, which may be relevant to the case, I order rehearing of Hugo Argent. Please summon the witness. There will also be a rehearing of Antoine Eaton, father of the accused, due to the suspicion that he had rented the room in which the murder was committed. And at this time, I announce a break. The next court session will be held tomorrow at the same time.
kitchen scum. You can be sure that you will take responsibility for what you have done to our daughter. You will be beheaded, and even neither your millions nor your connections will be able to help you. Is the stolen money not enough? Is your wrongdoing to all these poor people not enough? You had to tear everything away from us, including our only daughter. Death to the rich. Vive la nouvelle révolution. Chef, your father and I are quite sure that you did not do it. You couldn't have. We love you, and we are waiting for you at home. Please, leave this cursed Paris and return to your home parts. Mama et Papa. P.S. Papa asks you not to mention the hotel guestbook. Apparently you know what that means. Mon cher, I am in a deep regret that you had to stand before the court accused of such a terrible deed. I assure you that I deeply believe in your innocence and will do my best so that you can continue to work for the glory of Le Feu and toute la France. Cordialement, Hugo Argent.
Monsieur Ethan, please hurry. The court is already in waiting.
Bienvenue, messieurs. We are all present, so we can begin. To begin with, I inform you that Hugo Argent submitted further clarifications on the letter from the attorney's office discussed yesterday. His testimony has been attached to the evidence. Antoine Eaton, too, has submitted clarification on the issue of the rented room in the Caucasus Hotel. It was attached to the evidence. Monsieur Eaton, please continue your testimony from the moment you've ended yesterday.
Next, I wanted to open the door to the restaurant, but it was closed because... Then I called the elevator. I opened the elevator. Then I took the elevator to the second floor. Then I opened the elevator grate. I opened the inner door. I opened the door and entered the room. As I walked in, Madame Capet was standing by the desk, counting money from the suitcase. She didn't notice me. I drank some decent champagne. I told her to return my designs. It's obvious that she was interested only in the money because she gave them back without hesitation. I left the room into the corridor.
So, you claim that you did not kill Marie Capet?
Oui, Monsieur le Président. When I left the room, Marie Capet was still alive.
I understand. Please continue, Monsieur Eaton.
Then I opened the door. I called the elevator. Then I opened the elevator. Then I took the elevator to the first floor. I opened the elevator grate. I tried the door handle to the hotel room, but it was closed. I tried to open the door to the hotel room, but it was closed. I read cultural announcements. I called the elevator. I opened the elevator grate. Later, I took the elevator to the ground floor. Then, I opened the elevator grate. Later, I opened the door and walked out into the street. Then, I opened the gate. I opened the door and entered the building where my apartment is. Then I opened the door. Then I opened the elevator grate. Then I took the elevator to the second floor. I opened the elevator grate. Then, I opened the door to my apartment and entered. I watched the frames hanging on the wall. I loved their simplicity. I used the stairs. I opened the inner door. Then I changed into some clean clothes. I was tired after the banquet, so I immediately went to sleep. I was even too tired to undress.
Is it all you want to testify, Monsieur Eaton?
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
And so I close the hearing. It is time to present your positions.
Monsieur le Président, the accused tried to trick himself off the responsibility. He used cunning rhetoric, trying to hide more and more of his new lies. However, in view of the evidence presented by the prosecutor, I have no doubt that Alfred Eaton, defendant who appeared today before the court, murdered Marie Capet in cold blood. Please, let the High Court not be deceived by his tearful stories about a poor gypsy from the country who gained his success with hard work and which Marie Capet so cleverly tried to destroy. It was the accused who destroyed the life of a poor girl and her family with full premeditation. And what did that poor girl do to deserve such cruel fate? She was searching for a better life and was employed as a maid in the same building in which a dangerous psychopath lived. According to the prosecution, the accused is guilty, Monsieur le Président. Therefore, I apply for recognition of Alfred Eaton, defendant who appeared today before the court, guilty of all charges against him, and for imposition of the death penalty by beheading on the guillotine. Thank you. Monsieur le Président, Monsieur Prosecutor used a lot of high-flown words. However, during the preparation of indictment, he made many mistakes. As to the hotel room, my client had never rented a room in the Caucasus Hotel. As we have shown during the proceedings, it was his father, Antoine Eaton. It is supported by the hotel's guest book, graphology expertise, and the testimony of Antoine Eaton. As to the alleged attempt to use the torture device on the victim, my client did not intend to use his interrogation device, which the prosecutor describes as a torture machine, neither on Marie Capet nor on anyone else. This is indicated by the letter sent by my client to the Ministère de la Justice with a proposal of a lawful use of the equipment to serve the law as well as society. The journal of Alfred Eaton clearly proves it, where he writes that he does not intend to use his device against honest, innocent people. It is important to emphasize the relationship of Marie Capet and my client. According to the testimony of the victim's parents, she felt a deep resentment and contempt, both for my customer and for his work and success. As to the meeting with Marie Capet in his apartment, indeed, Marie Capet came to visit my client at his apartment, and Alfred Eaton let her in, not expecting such a sudden attack. Hence the victim's fingerprints in the apartment of my client, and traces of Monsieur Eaton's blood, which were mentioned by the prosecutor. As for the murder, as my client testified, he did not kill Marie Capet. So, who did? Please note, Monsieur le Président, that Alfred Eaton worked on a secret invention, which designs he kept hidden in his own safe. Neither Hugo Argent nor Le Feu Company were supposed to ever know about it. But that is not what happened. Monsieur Argent not only learned about the invention, but also wanted to come into its possession. This is indicated by a letter from a law firm that was sent to my client. As it clearly appears from the letter to Monsieur Brissot, the maid, Marie Capet, was sent shortly before the murder. I would like to add that the letter was sent from a non-existent organization, and remuneration for Marie Capet's work was not provided. So who and why had she been sent? In the same room that was rented by the father of the accused, Antoine Eaton. According to the testimony of Antoine Eaton, his son, Alfred Eaton, informed him about his problems with Hugo Argent. He wanted to help his son, so he used Marie Capet's aversion towards him and her difficult situation and hired her to steal the documents. So, if Alfred Eaton had ceased to possess them, he could have handed them over to Hugo Argent's lawyers. However, something must have gone wrong. Maybe Marie Capet demanded more money or started to blackmail Antoine Eaton. Maybe there was some kind of accident and she was killed. There are many different possibilities, and there is a slight chance they will get determined, so I think that there are too many doubts to convict my client. As for the testimony of the neighbor who saw Alfred Eaton entering the building covered in blood, according to my client's testimony, that meeting had never taken place, so the witness made a false testimony. Taking into account the evidence from the neighbor's opinions, the witness might have had a motive, an aversion towards my client, and racial prejudice. Thank you, Monsieur le Président. Monsieur Eaton,
The French Gypsy Association wishes to send you support and condolences for the persecution caused by your gypsy origin. We are aware that it was the main cause of your indictment. We offer you a safe haven if you decide to leave the prison in less official way. One of our persecuted members, who had also been imprisoned in the prison de la Santé, mentions the decayed walls in most of the cells. Maybe you could use this information. Signed, X. Take responsibility for what you have done to our daughter. You will be beheaded, and even neither your millions nor your connections will be able to help you. Is the stolen money not enough? Is your wrongdoing to all these poor people not enough? You had to tear everything away from us, including our only daughter. Death to the rich. Vive la nouvelle révolution. Jacob, your father and I are praying for you, and we believe that the court will be merciful. Maman et papa.
Thank you.